particular verse. Even one whole volume of Back to God magazine was published just on this verse. Bhajami Aham. Now, how many of us wants a worship from Krishna? I don't think so. Nobody. But he's ready to worship. So Srila Prabhupada explained that means just like mother or father, they are elder. But when it is required, no matter how old they are, no matter how their children are, whatever condition, they are ready to do anything for their children. So how many of you as a parent would do anything for your children? All of us, right? That's our love for them. Most of us, we work very hard just for them, for their well-being. Same way Krishna is ready to do that. And that's what Srila Prabhupada is explaining us, giving us the knowledge and conviction. See, we have this understanding because we do experience the reciprocation of Krishna anyway. Just like because you came here, got together, took special time and did wonderful, you know, you spend time together, reward would be prasadam. Delicious. That is given by Krishna only. He first honors, enjoys, and then he gives. We all get rewards immediately. Similarly, any activity, one very wonderful statement is made, Krishna never keeps anybody's on his head. If you like any debt on his head. Even smallest to the biggest thing you do, no matter what, he would reciprocate or pay you back. He would never keep on his head. So that kind of father we all have. And that introduction is given by Srila Prabhupada. How to connect with him. How to achieve the highest in our life. So summarizing, Srila Prabhupada gave us this process. First is he created a family, the Society of International Society for Krishna Consciousness, by which we all, no matter where we are born, what we are, age difference, we might have everything different when we come together as a Bhakti Vruksha. This also pleases Krishna the most. Because some of the parents might have experienced one of the very happy moments in their life is when their children stay together, play together, eat together, and they are happy. If they are fighting their differences, that makes them very sad or unhappy. Right? Everybody agrees that? Very simple truth. Even Lord Brahma told Devta and Danavas, when they both, you know, all the demigods and demons, when they went to him as a father, grandfather, he said, just be together, cooperate with each other, that will make me happy. And then he also gave the way, churn the ocean, and you'll get all the blessings, all the good things. So they did that. Srila Prabhupada's last instruction was same thing. What was his last instruction? Cooperate among each other. You may not like each other sometimes, someday. But still, be friendly, be nice to each other. And that is the desire of every father also. So these are the secrets. So still, there is so much to talk. I'll continue the very same subject in a different facets. In our meetings or discussion at the temple and also the program on Monday. Thank you very much for giving me opportunity to come here among all of you, because this also empowers me, enlivens me and charges me. What I am saying is only I am sharing what I heard. But I'm also listening same thing one more time. So it strengthens my faith in my heart. Any way I can serve you right now or in future, please feel free. One thing, you can always serve me by asking question. Pari prashnina sevaya. Or you can share your experience or some, you know, sharing the knowledge what you have. It will be my pleasure to enjoy it with you. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki. Anybody has anything to ask or share, please? Any question? Yes, please.
Thank you, Prabhuji, for such a wonderful class. Prabhu, back to Godhead, sometimes we wonder that, we know that it's only Krishna's mercy and, you know, your Guru mercy, that and ultimately we don't have any qualifications, they will pull us back. But I was wondering, basically I've heard the two explanations. One says, until we have any desire to enjoy material things, we will be here until we completely purify ourselves. And another explanation says, if we manifest our love for Krishna more than what we love we have for the material things, then also Krishna can take us back.
Wonderful, wonderful question actually. So he must be listening very carefully. And he is very eager to go. Because this is obstacle, you know, he made the point. We all have material desire, guaranteed. So there is one verse in it says, until, so material desire, what it does, do you know what material desire does? Material desire is only side effect. Those, how many of you are doctors here? Medical profession? So you know that there is some big infection in the body. The outcome is fever, vomiting, this, that, all the symptoms are there. So material desire is actually symptoms. It's not the cause. What is the real cause? Anybody knows?
Lust.
Happiness.
One is lust.
Happiness.
Happiness.
Separation.
Envy. That is the main cause. So it says the moment you become envious, you don't need this body. The body becomes useless for you. Immediately, that moment. Now that is very tricky thing, or most difficult thing. Actually, most difficult thing to get out of envy. Because normally we see children, they have the most purest form in human life, right? Or stage, right? They are born just recently and they just depend completely on parents. They don't want to go away for 1 second from the mother or father. They start crying, right? And they are taken care of for everything. So it's a like natural, total dependent. Like a devotee is completely dependent on Krishna, then we say he's the greatest devotee, right? Similarly, child is considered in that, you know, consciousness. But as soon as two siblings, one sibling, you give one toy, another toy, immediately, why you are not giving me? They start crying. In this early stage of existence also envy is there. So envy, now it's very hard to go out of envy, very hard. You know, there is a process given in all the three scriptures, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Ishopanishad. Nectar of Devotion also gives a lot of information about it. A lot of steps, processes, stages, examples are there. But Prabhupada gave the best solution, which I was going to share maybe other time, but Prabhuji asked, so I'll share immediately now. Because I like to follow the footsteps of Prabhupada. Prabhupada wanted to give the best. Her mother, when she cooks something best, she likes to give first to the children. Because it's more nourishing, more enjoyable. So Prabhupada said, first, that because Krishna is extremely eager to bring his child back, he is not very much concerned if his child played in the mud or he has a torn clothes or he is dirty, this, that. That is not his major concern, just like mother. When child comes from the playing outside and if he has mud, everything, still mother, what she would do? Just give the child a hug because she is meeting after some time, right? She is not saying why you did this, 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 this. So Krishna, this becomes secondary for Krishna, all these things. But the only thing is, child or soul, if he starts thinking, I do not want to go and give hug to my mother or father or Krishna, then Krishna has only one problem. What is the biggest problem in the principle of Krishna is, for all of us? He is not dictator. He has given freedom to all of us. So he cannot come and grab us. You have to do this. You are my child. No, he won't do that. But he is on the contrary, most loving father. So he fulfills the desire all of us. So he makes us, when we separate from him, he makes us Lord Brahma. He gives us all kingdom. You enjoy. If you want to enjoy without me, you have freedom. So, but Prabhupada gave this thing. So, what happens? If I want to come in this house, I have to be friend with Sri Govind Prabhu, right? Anybody walking on the road cannot just ring the bell and say, Prabhuji, I want to take a bath in your house and sleep. What do you say? Right? But you become Bhakti Vruksha member, yes, automatically happens. But there is better example is, you become friend of Aditi or Abhay. And Abhay comes and says, Papa, this is my best friend. Can he come in our house? What will be the answer? What will be the answer? Definitely yes. Now remember, I might be the worst person. We all do this. See, in normal case, we are very, very careful who our children or our friends are. Somebody say, in general, doing something not good, or we think is not good, right? Then we try to keep away, right? Somebody is chain smoker. He cannot stop smoking. So we'll say, better he doesn't come in our house. Because we don't want to go through the process of secondhand smoke, right? So same way, there are many other activities we don't like it. But as soon as our child says, he's my best friend, can he come? We overlook all the negativities. So Srila Prabhupada said, that if somehow or other you are able to please him, he would come at the time of death no matter what and hold our hand and take us back home, back to God and to Krishna. Promise. It is his promise. And he gave specific activities what to do and how to please him. And they are not complicated. They are very simple. And that is not only his desire, that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself also instructed. In Chaitanya Chaitamrita there are verses about it. So at that time he also, you know, he was asked again and again. So he said, Prabhupada said, I have a backdoor entry of Golok Vrindavan. You may not be qualified in general way, but I'll let you go into the back. That much merciful he is. Thank you for asking a wonderful question. Anybody else? Yes, please. You can come forward, please.
The Bhagavad Gita tells the story of Kurukshetra.
Yes.
What story does the Srimad Bhagavatam tell?
Wow. See, these are the very intelligent question, and not many people know this. So, Bhagavad Gita is a only small portion of Mahabharata. Mahabharata is the whole history of Pandavas and Kauravas and their dynasty. So when Krishna tried to stop the war and went as a Duta to Duryodhana, please don't do this, it's not good. Duryodhana said, no matter what, I want to fight, I won't give even the smallest land to him, to Pandavas. So there was a war. So Arjuna wanted to see what is happening, and he requested Krishna to take the chariot in the middle of the two armies and see who is on which side. And he saw Bhishma Pitama and then Dronacharya, his guru, and all the relatives on one side. And he said, how can I fight with my guru, my grandfather, my cousins, my brothers, my friends? And what I'll gain anyway? And whole Bhagavad Gita starts there. And then naturally there is a war after Bhagavad Gita, war happened, and lots of people were killed, and including Bhishma Pitama as well as Dronacharya, everybody, they left. So the last part was when Duryodhana was at the deathbed. He was wounded so badly by Bhima in Gada Yuddha that he was ready to leave body. He called Ashwatthama and said that he was very envious and very angry, so he wanted to take revenge. He told to Ashwatthama, you go and kill the sons of Pandavas, 5 children of Mother Draupadi. And naturally Ashwatthama is the son of Dronacharya, very learned, very good, well-trained warrior. So he becomes him, the chief of army. And he goes and kills the sleeping children of Pandavas or Mother Draupadi. So he does the most heinous activity. So technically, when Duryodhan was dead, that is the end of Mahabharata. Because that was the purpose. Dharma won and Adharma got destroyed. And right when Duryodhan instructs Ashwatthama to kill the sleeping children of Draupadi, Mata or Pandava, that is exactly where Srimad Bhagavatam starts. So chapter is Son of Drona Punished. And all this detail, what happened at that time, is supremely described. And it is actually very dear. This chapter is very dear to me. I read it as many times as I can, especially when I am in Bazaar. What to do? So I'd like to request all of you, whenever you have a really tough question to be answered or to do, should I do this or should I do this? Read this chapter, you'll get the answer immediately. And maybe tomorrow I'll try to summarize that chapter, because it's already 8:30. I don't want to make you hungry, because prasadam is most important service to Krishna.
One question.
Yes, please.
So when you say that Duryodhana instructed Ashwatthama to kill the sons of So it was as per the Bhagavatam, you said that Duryodhana didn't approve that request.
Duryodhana
never told Ashwatthama to kill the sons of Draupadi. So even though after this heinous kind, even though Duryodhana disapproved this request, the heinous kind gone by Ashwatthama, it was rejected by Duryodhana. Duryodhana didn't approve that. So that means Duryodhana never instructed to Ashwatthama to kill the sons.
So this is how the scripture says, Prabhupada explains this way. Duryodhan is a personality. He was able to see Krishna in the universal form exactly Krishna showed to Arjuna during the battlefield, during Bhagavad Gita. Think about it. Why Krishna would show the similar form to somebody who is so bad, right? On the other side, Krishna went to Duryodhan and said, my dear Duryodhan, please, you know this would bring havoc for the humanity. Please don't do this. So Duryodhan answered this in this beautiful verse, Janami dharmam nachame pravrutti. Janami adharmam nachame nivrutti. This was the answer to Krishna by Duryodhan. What is saying? Janami dharma. I know what is religion. But I have no liking or inclination to do that thing or participate in it. Same way, I know what is adharma. Janami adharmam nachame nivrutti. I know what is adharma, but I cannot get out of it. I cannot quit it. So that is his weakness, and he explains. I have been fed poison from my childhood by my father. I don't know, some of you might have, you know, read the stories and everything. Dhritarashtra, he was feeding him both physical and mental poison constantly. And that's how he did all heinous work. See, he knew what is religion, so he felt many things bad. Whatever he did, he felt just like in Mother Devaki. And, you know, when his brother Kamsa, he was trying to, you know, kill all the children. He knew he's not doing right. If you read very carefully the 10th canto, even when he takes the sword to cut the head of Devaki, Mother Devaki, when he hears the Akashvani, the saying from the sky that, you know, 8 child would be killing you. So he understands, you know, first, you know, how can I kill my sister? He loved his sister so much. In the history of mankind, nobody has killed their sister ever. So it will be the biggest deal. So he knew also the dharma, what is it? And sometimes if you go in the depth, he was very hesitant to do some of the heinous job. Same way Duryodhan has some repentance, you are right. But he had that so much hatred that he wanted to, just like Pandavas, including Bhima and Arjuna, they killed all the children of Dhritarashtra. So he wanted to take revenge and kill all the children and grandchildren of Pandu, so there is nobody ruler in their house. That's how it is explained. Thank you. Anybody else? So here, thank you so much one more time. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.